What is wine flower? At 26 years old, I've been asking myself this question for over 5 years now. In that time, I've gone from a focus in renewable energy to sustainable agriculture with a specialization in gourmet food production. I've asked myself this question thousands of times, and now thousands of others are asking me. But like all questions and lessons, there are numerous layers that need to be peeled in order for the answers to be seen. In my first lesson, I needed to know where wine flower came from in order to truly understand what it is or what it could be. Wine flower is made from wine grape skins after the wineries press the grapes for their juice. Wineries create a product they call grape pumice. Pumice is made up of seeds, skins, and sometimes stems, with about 80% of pumice being skin and 20% of pumice being seed. Wineries generally throw away this valuable resource, but many would rather not, and most producers I have met would prefer to have limited to zero waste streams. However, time is a limiting factor here and an infinite lesson reminding us that we can never do anything alone. So in my first lesson, I learned that if I were to target the skins of the grapes, that I would be making the quickest impact. I also learned that by offering to remove pumice from winery press pads, I would be making some farmers extremely happy. In my second lesson, I needed to figure out how I was going to bring this innovative flower to market and how I was going to set Finger Lakes wine flower apart from the rest. Although we target the skins of the pumice for our flowers, all of the pumice has value. By separating the seeds from the skins, drying this material using passive solar dehydration, grinding the skins into really fine powders, and hand sifting these powders is how our wine flour is made. We save the seeds for grapeseed oil, which we have not yet released. Although grapeseed oil is high in proteins, fats, omega-6s, and omega-9s, it's extremely difficult to make, as grapeseeds are about 5% oil at best. In my second lesson, I learned that by minimizing the use of equipment, our process ensures that when you cook or bake with our flours, your recipes will be packed with flavor and nutrition. In my third lesson, I needed to figure out if wine flour could be important enough to establish new markets and turn something very few have ever heard of into a household item. Wine flour is gluten-free, high in protein, fiber, antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals. The flavors mimic the grapes they come from and are various shades of purple if they are a red variety, or gold if they are a white variety of grape. They are a baking and cooking supplement, not a substitute, meant to add flavor, color, and nutrition to any and all recipes. In each pound of wine flour, you have 100 grams of protein and 150 grams of fiber. This is why they must be treated as a supplement. Although our company specializes in gluten-free baking, you are not required to bake gluten-free. And if baking isn't for you anyway, you're not required to bake with them at all. Our wine flour is great to thicken any sauce, from mac and cheese to gravy, to any cream, chicken, beef, or duck sauce you can think of. They are great for thickening a stew or a pie filling, for making purple bread, purple pasta, and yes, purple pancakes too. When I was first learning how to use wine flour in baking and cooking, I did not take into account this high fiber and protein content. I decided I would make purple biscuits with the Cabernet Sauvignon. I did a 1-to-1 ratio of wine flour to all purpose. The batter was thick and extremely hard to stir, yet I put them in the oven anyway. And upon making it out of the oven, however, my purple biscuits turned into purple rocks. There are 16 tablespoons in a cup, so the proper baking ratio is actually 1 to 16, or at most 1 to 8. As long as you treat wine flower as a supplement, you will quickly learn that the flavors, color, and nutrition can offer something unique to your recipes. In my third lesson, I also needed to know just how much of an impact I could potentially be making by producing wine flower. Well, at first the numbers were overwhelming. The Finger Lakes wine industry produces over 11,000 tons of grape pumice annually. That number is only growing. In the last three harvest seasons, our company has collected over 60 tons of grape pumice. We, too, are only growing. So in my third lesson, I learned that I would be crazy not to try to harvest these valuable nutrients, these valuable flavors, from such a healthy piece of fruit. Not only would I be providing nutrition in a new and exciting way, but I would be able to help farmers and the environment while doing so. And finally, none of these lessons, none of these questions would be able to be answered without the existing industries which wine flower was born from. Without the Finger Lakes wine industry or the Finger Lakes farm-to-table movement, it'd be extremely difficult for Finger Lakes wine flower to exist at all. It's been almost 200 years since the first vines were planted in the Finger Lakes. In that time, we have grown from just 1 acre of grapes to over 11,000 acres. We have grown from a handful of wineries operating before Prohibition to over 120 operating today. We are producing more pumice than ever, so increasing our area's viability by utilizing all of our resources is essential. But the Finger Lakes did not always look this way, and in the early 70s, grape farmers were actually moving out of the area because government policy would not allow direct sales to customers. For the farmers that stayed, their dedication paid off when a bill was passed which lifted the retail restraint on New York State wine. Within 9 years after this bill, the amount of wineries in our area had tripled. It's safe to say that without the pioneers from the Finger Lakes wine industry, the Finger Lakes would look much different today. And the same can be said for the Finger Lakes farm-to-table movement. In the early 90s, almost no restaurants in the Finger Lakes were farm-to-table. People said they were too expensive, and at the time, TV dinners were still extremely popular. However, there was one woman who stuck to her mission and her passion to create local gourmet food, and she began a farm-to-table restaurant called Red Newt Bistro. Within a decade, there were scores of farm-to-table restaurants popping up all over the Finger Lakes. And today, there are hundreds of farm-to-table restaurants across New York State. Being born and raised in the Finger Lakes, I've had the pleasure of working with some of the best chefs, the best winemakers, grape growers, researchers, hardest workers, and most passionate friends that this world will ever see. It's this dedication to new ideas that has made wine flower possible. Wine flower is innovative, it's nutritious, it's flavorful, it's sustainable. It's the wine industry, the farm-to-table movement. It's being a community of pioneers. So let me ask you one more time. What is wine flower? To me, wine flower is being able to drink our wine and eat it too. Thank you.